What's up guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how you can install Trust Wallet on your phone. Yes, right on your phone. And all the things you need to do to make sure that you install Trust Wallet successfully and safely on your device. So let's get right into it. First we need to do is we need to go into Play Store and download it. Once we download it from there, we're going to continue how to set it up. And don't forget, you need a piece of paper with you, seriously, because there are information you need to write down. So get a piece of paper while you're following this process, how to install it. Get a pen, pencil, and get ready to write down some very important information that you should never lose, seriously. Never lose. So let's get right into it. Let me show you how you can set it up. Go ahead and click on Trust Wallet, then come down and click on Get Started. Click on it. After that, just give it a couple of minutes to process. So we're gonna come over here and click on Create a New Wallet. If I have a wallet already, I'll click on Add Existing Wallet. So I'm just going to click on create a new wallet instead of clicking on adding existing wallet. Okay, so now I'm going to come here and click on backup to Google Drive instead of backup manually, instead of writing the phrase down. So what we're backing up is the secret phrase. So I'm going to click backup to Google Drive so that it will back it up to my Google Drive, which is much easier than writing it out. So now I'm going to give it a name, backup name. I'm going to call my Trust Wallet. That's what I'm going to call mine. So I'm just going to go ahead and type it in. So after typing it, I'm going to come down here and click on continue. Yep, that's good. Trust Wallet. So I'm going to click on continue. Okay, so right now it's processing. Let's give it a couple of minutes. We're gonna choose our email. So I'm gonna choose my email. Email that is to connect to. So that's why I just clicked on now, the email I wanted to connect to. Then now I'm gonna grant it some access to my information. So let's see the first access I need to grant it. The first one is sign into Trust Wallet. I'm going to click on continue. The next one is Trust Wallet wants to access your Google account. So I'm going to scroll down and click on continue. Yep, we're going to continue. Then give it a couple of minutes to process that. Okay, now the Trust Wallet wants access to your Google account again. So now we're now going to scroll down and click on allow. Okay, so after that, at this point I can't record my screen anymore, so I'm recording from another phone. So right here it says sign in to Trust Wallet. We're gonna click on continue. Then okay, still the same process again. So I'm just gonna scroll down and click on continue. So this is the same process that we have done already. So right now we need to put in our password. So our password has to be 8 characters long. It has to have a number, it has to have a capital letter, at least one, and a symbol. You can see it here. Password must contain 8 or more characters with at least one lowercase letter, one uppercase letter and number, and one symbol. So I'm gonna go ahead and start typing it. Immediately as I'm typing it, you notice that this red would change, the color would change to show that okay, I have fulfilled one of the terms. So we have a lowercase, so it's now blue. So once I add a number, it will also change to blue. Once I have add a capital letter, that text will also change to blue. But no, depending on your device, the color could change to green too. So some things might be a bit different depending on the device that you are currently downloading TrustWallet on. So after we're done typing it, we're going to move on to the next page. Yep. So this is it right here. You can notice everything is all blue now. That's because I have fulfilled the requirement or the password. So next I'm going to click on next. This next down there, just gonna click on that. So I'm gonna repeat it again. Now at this point, I advise you to write your password out on a piece of paper, because you're gonna agree to some terms, and one of those terms is TrustWallet cannot recover my secret phrase encryption password. Now that is, if you lose your password and if you lose your secret phrase, you won't be able to access your TrustWallet, and automatically you will lose any money on that TrustWallet account. So this is it right here. You can see the first term, then you can see the second one. I say I understand that if I lose or forget this password, I would lose access to my crypto, which is really not a good thing if you ever forget your password. So I advise write it down in more than one place so that you don't forget it, because to continue you need to click the little box on the left hand side. You'll notice it once I click on those boxes, they'll become blue. Then that's it. So now I can go ahead and confirm that I agree to that. I am aware that if I lose my password, there's a chance I've lost everything in my TrustWallet, which is very dangerous. So please write down your password and keep it safe from people. This is not something easy anybody can guess too. So while we wait for it to process, now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a passcode. Note that if your phone has a fingerprint option, you can also scan your fingerprint and also use it to access your account instead of typing in your passcode. So I'm going to put in my passcode here. Yep. Then I'm going to repeat it again. You're going to repeat it 2 times. So this is the second time. Now I'm going to confirm for biometrics login. Then I'm going to scan my fingerprint now. So go ahead and put your finger, the one you want to use to open your account, on where your sensor of your fingerprint is. Once you are done with that, boom. Your account has been created. So you can see right now I have fully created my TrustWallet account, so I can now go ahead and transfer money there. If you like this video, go ahead and subscribe.